Jurassic World Dominion, the sixth chapter in the long-running dinosaur series, was pushed back a full year due to the 2020 pandemic. If we were on our original schedule, the film would actually be coming out in just a few weeks' time this June, but now we have to wait for 2022 to see Alan Grant, Ellie Sattler, Owen and Claire, and everyone else in the new entry. With that being said, the filmmakers have been teasing an official trailer for the movie a lot lately, and if rumors are to be believed at face value, it's going to be coming out sooner than any of us can expect. Hey guys, hope you're all doing well. Now for today's video, I wanted to talk about Colin Trevorrow's recent interview in which the director revealed that a new Jurassic World trailer was on the way. Talking to The Hollywood Reporter, Colin said, quote, "It's going to be sooner than you think. I can't talk about it just yet. We've got something fun planned, and it has everything to do with getting people back in the movie theaters." This information was revealed in an interview on season 3 of the hit Netflix series Camp Cretaceous, which takes place in between Jurassic World and Fallen Kingdom, while also paving the way for some cool stuff that we're told could wind up being a big deal in Dominion. Now, how soon is sooner than we think? Well, most people seem to be under the impression that Trevorrow could be hinting at a trailer drop sometime around June for the release of the new Fast and Furious movie, which happens to also be a Universal property. Just so you guys know, I'd heard rumblings about a trailer coming out soon for a while now, but nobody really thought it was anywhere near being that early from what I had heard. In fact, this kind of comes as a surprise to a lot of us because the film is still a full year away from a wide release. But Jurassic World is on a pretty solid high right now after receiving a ton of positive reviews for all three seasons of Camp Cretaceous and the 2019 film Battle at Big Rock, which was also widely celebrated. So maybe Universal wants to strike iron while it's hot and get the trailer out there for people to keep the Jurassic Park conversation going for as long as humanly possible. Now, as far as Colin's words on the trailer drop being related to getting people back into movie theaters, I think I might have an idea on what he could be talking about. So, as we all know, theater attendance has been down a lot since 2020, and most people are opting to stay home and watch new films on HBO Max or Disney Plus these days. But what if the trailer to Jurassic World Dominion, the movie that we've all been waiting for ever since that T-Rex roared at the lion 3 years ago, what if that trailer is going to be exclusive to movie theaters when it's first released? What I mean by that is, and this is just my opinion, I think it's totally a possibility for the Dominion trailer to be a theater-only release where we don't get to see it on the internet until Fast and Furious 81 or whatever number they're on gets done making some money. Now, I think this is actually a big possibility for a number of reasons, mainly because Jurassic World at one point in time was actually supposed to have a major release like this for not only a trailer, but the Colin Trevorrow-directed short film that takes place a year after Fallen Kingdom. Battle at Big Rock, as many of you may remember, was originally slated to premiere as a surprise in front of Hobbs and Shaw, but due to the movie becoming more expensive and elaborate than originally envisioned, it had to premiere on YouTube later that same year. Now, the 10-minute Jurassic Park movie was met with a lot of positive reception and is currently listed as one of the higher-ranked entries on IMDb, but it also isn't really that well-known outside of the hardcore fan base. But had it premiered in the theater, then a whole lot of other people would have been talking about it. And that's why I think Universal could look at a theater-exclusive trailer for the next Jurassic movie in a very rewarding light. It would help the new Fast and Furious movie make more money because people like me would be buying a ticket to go see the trailer, and it would help give Jurassic something of a unique word-of-mouth campaign going a full year before the film even comes out. But then again, this is all just my own theory on the subject matter. Just so everyone's clear, The Hollywood Reporter actually went on to say that there would be some promotional push coming for Dominion, but they did not confirm whether or not it was meant to be a trailer or something else. Nevertheless, it definitely is part of the marketing campaign. Personally, I'd really like to see a trailer, but knowing how these things get worded and run off in different sort of articles and headlines, it could just be some sort of weird promotion that they've got to go alongside Jurassic World Dominion, where we don't technically get a teaser or a trailer, but maybe some still images, maybe some sort of movie theater exclusive offering that we could only get if we actually go to a physical location. That also sounds really, really cool, and I still have my money bet on that. This is probably got something to do with Fast and Furious. It's kind of weird that we waited so long for Jurassic World, 14 years in between JP3 and the fourth entry. Meanwhile, Fast and Furious made literally one, two, three, four, five, six, maybe even seven films in between JP 3 and 4, and we're only on Jurassic Park 6 now. So what are all of your thoughts on this Dominion news? And did you expect to hear about a trailer this early? Whatever your own thoughts and opinions happen to be, I'd love to hear them in the comments down below. Now before I go, I'd like to thank all of my game wardens, as well as all of my engine executives. I'd also like to thank all of my park workers and engine hunters as well. Guys, it seriously means the world to me that you all continue to support what I do, and I never want you to ever forget that. Now, I'd like to thank you all for watching today's video and hope you all enjoyed the content. If you feel like I deserve it, I'd appreciate the like and hope that you'll consider subscribing if you're interested in seeing me again. See you all in the next video, guys, and as always, take it easy.